Oh, sharp black stones, an unknown constellation of stars, circling an uproar of ashen faces. He awakens in the sweat of this dream, crying, Matux, and Maklak, human relatives, antlered ones in the awake. Inside the cedared lodge, they dance, inhaling the course of lost river whistles and drums, calling to ceremony, invisible counselor. The tulis are a blessing at my mother's fingers, working sheaves into inner silence of lost river bell. I remember listening to her, unseen movements dwelling in shapes of beauty, hearing her heartbeat, and like parent birds who perch with insects on the edge of the nest. She senses my hunger, lowers the beaks of her eyes, fills me with what she has seen, and my ears hear the clicking of elk teeth above my head. A serpent's sound, entwining my hands and feet. Relatives pass gaming bones back and forth, singing for cast-offs of gray ashen faces. Like this cloak I wear, tattered blue war shirt, to witness the source of their power. And I dream ravens, sealed, crazed inside glass bottles. Golden stones falling from the sky. Trembling earth that sucks the light from my eyes. And I can hear the whispers from water brash. Kinpuash. Kinpuash. And the last I breathe to these three relatives lying on either side. Thank you.
I'm the hunter.